What's up, everyone? It's me, Ivan. And today we're back into fixing the Acolyte. Now, if you haven't seen, I've had other videos of like this, so go and watch them. And if you're wondering, Ivan, please tell me, oh Lord of the Tacos, how do I watch you edit live? Well, it's very easy. Just click the notification button. I do announce the live editing sessions about 5 hours before they happen. So that's the best way. Like, I don't have a set schedule or anything. But if you say, oh, Ivan, I missed the live stream, how can I watch it again? Just become a channel member for like 99 cents or something, or like $2 a month. I think that's how much it is. But yes, if you're a channel member, you can rewatch those live edits. They're about like 2 to 3 hours in length, and you can see my thought process, like everything behind it, trial and error and stuff. Anyways, so today we're going to try to fix this scene of the infamous fire in space. All right, so let's remember, it's not about cutting things away and just like, you're out because I don't like you. It's about making it good, making it make sense. One thing that I think this show really, 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 really hurts the audience with is the pacing. The pacing of the show is just, it drags on a lot of places. So before we go into the infamous fire scene, let me show you originally what this scene looked like. So we have our second main character, what's her name? Osha? This is Osha, right? She wakes up and she's doing like this thing for whatever the fuck reason. Cracks the knuckles. Then the robot wakes up.
Good morning, Pip.
She says good morning to the robot, takes the blanket off, goes to the robot.
Whoa, inside voices, Pip.
I guess she was drunk last night or something for the inside voices comment.
Thank you. Sounds like we got a job.
And then we have... All right, let's move it. So whenever I re-edit anything, I have to ask myself, what's the purpose of this scene? What does this scene serve? Now, this scene showed us that she lives in a ship. She has a robot friend, and she's about to go to work. Can we just make that happen faster? So she wakes up.
Good morning, Pip.
That's it. Because here's the thing. Check this out.
Osha, why didn't you come out last night? You missed a wild trip to Nashadar with the piloting crew.
So right off the bat, we have a character explaining that she's part of a crew. So we establish like there's a little robot. Yes, there's a little robot that she's kind of friends with. But we just want to speed it along. And because we already know that she's about to do a job or that she's part of a crew, we don't need the little red light or anything. So we can just move along.
Yeah.
What I do with my days off is none of your business, Philip.
What I do with my days off. So we know that she's at her workplace. Do we need to establish that she's about to do a job at her workplace? No. That's why we can just edit the little red flashing lights. But now that's just a minor thing. That's just a minor thing. This is the important part. This is what you guys came in for. You wanted to see how this fire in space was going to be fixed, and I'm about to show you how.
Because Philip is clearly disposable, but me, on the other hand, come on.
So they have this conversation in this soundstage. I mean, this the vastness of space.
Very funny. The emitter dock doesn't connect it to the field projector.
Yep, I see it.
So she's doing her work. And this is when it happens.
Wait, the pressure gauge is spiking. And that was the pressure valve.
And there we have the infamous fire in space scene. Yay.
I got it.
This is what happens later. And this is, like, remember what I told you about, like, you need to figure out what's important. What's the importance of things, right? You remember? Well, this is the importance of things with this. The importance of this scene is to let us know that fire is triggering a little memory, like something happened. So that's what this scene is for, to show us that she has like a past that is kind of haunting her. But can we make it better? Because fire in space is, it's kind of like, you know, it's kind of silly and affects the pacing. So this is what's going to happen. If we continue with the scene, she fixed the thing. And then the Jedi come.
Jedi?
Friends of yours?
And then we see him say, friends of yours? That's how the scene plays out. So here, this is the thing. We don't have the fire because I utilized the sleeping scene. I am going to create a flashback type of moment where the tree and other certain like important elements from her past, instead of just hearing voices, she was dreaming about it. So now we have already established that she that her past kind of haunts her. And because eventually she'll be the one to turn to the dark side, all of these conflicting memories will play a part in the movie. So we established them from the beginning that things are like haunting her, right? That's what we're establishing from the get-go. And we take this as a moment for her to wake up and realize, like, okay, so now she wakes up for a reason. She wakes up for a reason. And we have already established that she actually suffers the thing. So instead of having just the fire and hearing the voices and her just staring, instead of that, she just fixes the thing.
I'll hold it together.
So she was just doing her job, and then she heard the ship and looked up, and there's the ship. And then we have the first Jedi.
Jedi?
And instead of cutting back to the female being like, again, we just stay with that. Like, it's his thing. Oh, Jedi, they're about to like infiltrate this thing. Oh, okay, whatever. We go into
friends of yours.
Now, there you go. Now the fire has been extinguished from our lives. And we already established that there's a past haunting her. The point of this scene originally with the fire is to establish that she's being haunted by the past. But if we can establish it before, then we can just skip to the important part. We have already established also that she knows how to fix things. So whenever she fixed things in the future, we've already seen it. And even to her credit, she was doing it from the first go. Instead of like blowing something up or whatever, like she's a mechanic. Like she does that. We don't see her fail immediately at her job. We see that she's just doing her job, but we establish from the get-go as the first impression of the character that she's haunted by the past. Not later in the scene, like 4 minutes after we introduce the character, we present this idea that she's having conflicting thoughts in the back of her head. We establish it from the get-go with this made-up flashback scene. And that's how you improve the pacing. So anyways, that's the fix that I have for today on the space fire. Let me know if you like this type of videos. Go ahead and comment, like, subscribe, all the thing. Remember, if you're a channel member, you can rewatch the live edits whenever I do this live. And if you're not a channel member, you can still watch them. Just keep up to date whenever I announce them, so you can watch them when they happen. When they happen, they're free. All right, that's what I have for today. I'll see you later. Bye.